As Mortimer had planned, Napoleon Bonaparte sold Louisiana to the United States after purchasing it from Spain. Bonaparte continued his political and military ascension until he proclaimed himself emperor. He went on to invade a large part of Central Europe. The legend of Napoleon persisted after his death, conferring on the emperor the role of Messiah for France. Napoleon Bonaparte continued his political and military rise until his self-proclamation as emperor. His excessive ambition would cost the lives of 1,700,000 Frenchmen and leave France poorer and weaker than ever before. Deported and imprisoned by the British on St. Helena Island, he died on the 5th of May, 1821, as an exile to general indifference. Remaining very popular, George Washington put an end to the various internal rebellions without violence and re-established trade agreements with Great Britain. Upon his death, he became a national hero and left an entire nation in a state of mourning. During his second term, George Washington had to deal with a number of rebellions. He enraged public opinion by building close diplomatic links with Great Britain, which forced him to give up a third term in office. He retired to his country estate until his death, without being able to implement the annexation of the highly coveted Louisiana Territory. On his return to Spain, Manuel Godoy proceeded to give Louisiana up to France. Later on, he became the target of the Crown Prince of Spain, Ferdinand VII. The latter gave no respite to his mother's lover, going as far as condemning him to exile. He confiscated all of Manuel's titles and possessions, as well as those of his mistress, Pepita. Pursued, they ended up living out their last years in France in poverty and anonymity. Manuel Godoy's close relationship with Napoleon enabled him to claim a part of Portugal, as well as the protection of France upon the fall of the kingdom. He died in the company of his beloved mistress, Pepita, after recovering all his titles and properties. The influence von Wollner had over King Frederick William ironically ended up working against him. The sovereign thrust him into increasing repression until the end of his reign. Von Wollner became the object of the people's hatred, was therefore stripped of his titles and land by the new king, and died in poverty to general indifference in the Prussian countryside. Von Wollner tightened his political and spiritual grip on King Frederick William. On the death of the king in 1797, Johann retired with his wife to his country estate in order to continue his work on his theological and alchemical thesis. On his return to Paris, Peyrou gave himself up to his peers of the revolutionary courts. He admitted to being implicated in several state corruption cases. Found guilty of treason toward the Republic, he was executed without a trial. On his return to Paris, Peyrou resigned from his posting as judge at the revolutionary courts. He withdrew to the south of France with his daughter until his death. Elizabeth's family did everything in their power to find her, based on clues provided by their friend George Washington. In vain, they lost her trail in the port of Brest in France, and no one ever saw her again. Sarah de Richet threw herself from the Pont des Arts into the River Seine before a crowd of dumbfounded bystanders just a few days after her son's return to Paris. He spoke of his aging mother's recent depression and took over the running of the Golden Order, whose expansion was rapid. Sarah de Richet never returned from her trip to the English Isles. Her disappearance spelled the end for the Golden Order, and was the object of gossip for just a few days at the court of France. Sarah de Richet stepped down from the Golden Order and undertook numerous excursions to Eurasia in search of her son. She reportedly lived out her last moments in a yurt on the way back from the Verkhoyansk mountain range. She died ranting and raving about needing a new body. Sarah de Richet was never the same after the death of her son, Louis. she threw herself wholeheartedly into the development of the Golden Order. Although some qualified her theories as fanciful, she remained a leading figure of feminism of the 18th century. Sarah de Richet suddenly left Paris, perhaps France even, when she found out about the death of her son off the coast of England. She left the Golden Order without appointing a successor. The order declined over the following years. His Eminence Piaggi paid dearly for disobeying His Holiness over his vote at the conference. It was consequently decided to withdraw him from diplomatic and political decision-making within the Papal States. It was rumored that his great age got the better of him, and he was sent to end his days in a Tuscan monastery, where he died 2 years later. His Eminence was obliged to justify himself on his return over the letter he had sent to His Holiness. His mental health was called into question, and consequently he was withdrawn from papal state power. It was said in polite undertones that he had been sent to a faraway retreat, the better to hide his anonymous confinement in an asylum of Rome. His Eminence Piaggi, having successfully accomplished his mission, returned to His Holiness the Pope with full honors. Although all his ambitions had become possible, to the stupefaction of his entourage, the cardinal preferred to retire to his Tuscan monastery, far from all political and diplomatic commitments. Fascinated by the techniques of exorcism and demonology, he dedicated the last years of his life to the study of Inquisition reports. The Duchess, through her relationship with the Crown, made it possible for Great Britain to build closer links to the United States on both the diplomatic and the commercial fronts. She became inseparable from the Marchioness Cunningham, reputed for being the most influential mistress of King George IV of England, and whom she inducted into the Golden Order. The Duchess, enabling Great Britain to build closer ties with the United States on both political and commercial fronts, was her last diplomatic feat. She gradually withdrew from the English court and had to retire to the country, supported by her ever-present friend, the author Jane Austen. They say that the Duchess inspired her novel, Emma, which became a bestseller in the year 1816. The Duchess remained close for a few years to the royal couple, until George III's health inexplicably worsened. She suddenly vanished from the royal court upon the advent of the regency of the Prince of Wales, George IV. No more was ever heard of Lord William Mortimer. His sudden disappearance was the subject of conversations in the European courts, but only for a few months.